Can science look like magic? You bet. You're about to learn a series of magic tricks that are based on scientific principles. You can perform these as magic tricks, or you can use them to demonstrate a scientific principle. Let's get started. This is one of the best science magic tricks that you can perform because it actually looks just like a real magic trick. Just as I showed you in the demonstration, you just place the card on top of the glass, turn it over. Now hold the card tightly against the glass, turn it over, and you can release your hand and the card won't fall and the water won't pour out until you pull the card away. Here's how it works. First of all, there's surface tension of the water that causes a seal to occur between the card and the glass. But what really makes the magic happen is air pressure, which is all around us. 14.7 pounds per square inch, or PSI, is pushing all around us. And while it seems counterintuitive, it doesn't seem like it could possibly work. The air pressure outside is greater than the water pressure inside, and thus when you release your hand away, the card stays and the water doesn't pour out. And again, this is one of the best magic tricks you can perform that's based strictly on science. Check it out. Inside of this bottle, where I can't touch it, is my magic diver here. Let's see if I can command it to do something here. We're just going to wave the hand, command it to go down. And I think that's happening right there. And now back up. Back up again. And up again. Take a packet, place a paper clip on there for weight, and now place it inside of your empty water bottle. Now you fill your bottle with water. First of all, you may have to balance the packet that's inside of the water here. Turns out I had to use two paper clips, so it was just at that right point. So if it sinks to the bottom, you have too big of a paper clip on it. If it stays at the top and you can squeeze it with the water all the way to the top, when you squeeze, it just goes right down. And when you release, it goes right back up. To perform this trick, all you do is squeeze the bottle. It will cause the little diver inside to move down to the bottom, and when you release the bottle, it'll cause the little diver inside to come back up. So how does this work? Well, there's water pressure inside of this bottle, and when you compress the water, you actually compress some of the air that's inside of that tiny little packet. Thus, the packet becomes more dense than the water beside it, and it begins to drop to the bottom as you squeeze and increase the water pressure. Gradually release the pressure on the bottle and the diver or packet becomes less dense and then rises to the top. I have strips of paper here. Let's see if we can do a little magic. Let's see if you can predict what's going to happen. First strip here. Going to cut all the way along the strip here. And you get two rings. Loop number two. same cut. And I get one big ring. Loop number three. Can you guess what's going to happen? Same cut. And we get two interlinked rings. In this trick, there are three variations on the loops that you create. All I've done here is taken an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper, cut 1.5 inch strips lengthwise and glued them together right here. And then at some point I'm going to glue them together to make the loops. Now, first one where we made two loops, identical loops, all I did was glue these together just like this, and this was cut and created the two loops. In the second one, you do what's called a half twist. So you take this and you twist it halfway like that, and then glue these together. This is the one that creates the loop of interest, the very long loop, and I will talk a little bit about the properties of that, which is significant to this, to the scientific angle to this magic trick. And finally, for the last one, where you have two interlinked loops, you twist it a full twist. So that would be a half twist and then a full twist, and then glue these ends together. And then when you cut lengthwise around this loop, you will get two interlinked loops. The key to this trick is that you twist these strips in different ways before having a spectator or yourself cutting them. The first one is just a very simple loop of paper, and that's why when you cut it through the center, it creates two loops of the same size and shape. With the second loop, you create a half twist before gluing the ends together. And so what happens here is when you cut through the center, you create one giant loop. Now this loop has special properties, which I'll talk about at the end of this segment. For the third loop, you actually create a full twist before gluing the ends together. Thus, when you cut through the middle, you create two rings that are locked together. This trick is based on something called a Möbius strip, named after August Ferdinand Möbius. The second loop is of interest because if you trace it all the way around, you'll notice that you'll go inside of the loop and then outside of the loop. This is very practical for applications such as conveyor belts because they will not tend to wear on just one side, they will wear on both sides. Now, this trick is a classic that's mentioned in a lot of magic books and apparently has been used by magicians in their act. Frankly, I'm not really sure what the magic is here. It just seems like it's a scientific demonstration of geometry and topology, but it's kind of fun and it's something you can do and perform for your friends.